गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज के भट्ट हियर। टुडे वंस अगेन आई एम हियर विद द एक्सरसाइज ऑफ द पोएम डस्ट ऑफ स्नो। दिस पोएम बेसिकली कंपोज्ड बाय रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट। आई एक्सप्लेन दिस पोएम इन द क्लास एज वेल एज थ्रू द वीडियो। आई होप एवरीथिंग हैज़ बीन क्लियर्ड। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, today I am going to explain the question of this particular chapter. Dear students, you know well that multiple choice question has been asked in the examination. That is why I am here with the multiple choice question, which is helpful to make you perfect for the examination as well as other examination which has been taken by the school. So dear students, be serious, take these points, understand and take a lot of benefits. See here the poem. The way a crow shook down on me the dust of snow from a hemlock tree has given my heart a change of mood, and some part of the day I had reviewed. Here are the poem. I think you have read this poem well. There is no problem in this particular poem. Now the question has been given here of the many symbols of hemlock tree represent. I also explained what type of symbol of hemlock tree and crow both represent. Here are given of the many symbols the hemlock trees represent, choose the one of the first tree upon in all likelihood for this poem symbol love. Here given four options: longevity, togetherness, healing, production. So I hope, what is the answer? Just I tell you at last. Think what is the correct answer. In this sequence I am just going to discuss the second question of this particular poem, that is, choose the option that lists the possible feeling of the poet prior to the experience shared in the. Look here. Sharing the feeling tenets of the poet prior to the experience shared in the poem. आप देख सकते हैं to the experience shared in the poem. Option one, reassured. Option two, second, disappointed. Third, curious. Fourth, demotivated. Fifth, thankful. Sixth, disheartened. And seven, impulsive. Now A, 1, 3 and seven. Second B, 2, 4 and six. C, 5 and seven. And D, 1 and three. These are the option. Okay, these are the option of this particular question. Now see here, the second third question. Identify the option that does not use the word review correctly. A, the film was a disaster and he reviewed his decisions to act in it. Listen here, identify the option that does not use the word review correctly. The film was a disaster and he reviewed his decision to act it in. Now the B option, I'm sure she reviewed the day she listened to the two-eyed June Taylor. C, it wasn't long before I reviewed my disobedience and my deceit. See here, B, I'm sure she reviewed the day she listened to a fortune teller. See, it wasn't long before I reviewed my disobedience and my dissent. And D, other finally rue the one who is dishonest and heartless. The student, just find out the correct answer by yourself. Now see here, I am going to explain the next. 4. Here are the 3. Others finally rue the one who is dishonest and heartless. Now see here, 5. Sanko is a poetic device that uses a part to represent the whole. Easy example, that is a great set of wheel has been used for car. Pick an example of Sanko from the poem. Have given my heart a change of mood, the way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from hemlock tree, and said some part of the day I had dreamed. Now you have to choose by yourself. Now see here the question number 5. Choose the option showing the reason not corresponding with a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow. The crow landing on a branch of the tree. See here, the crow landing on the branch of a tree. Second option B, the shivering of the crow due to the cold. Option C, readjustment of position of the crow on the branch. Crow on the branch. The coming of the crow hidden in foliage. Here are given total 5 multiple choice questions. And I have told you to find out the answer of that particular question. Then after you match the answer that has been given in the below. See here the first answer is C. Second B, third D, fourth A, fifth D. Now see here again. First C, second B, third D, fourth A, and fifth D. These are the 5 options: first C, second B, third D, fourth A, and fifth D. Fifth जो आपका है D है. So I hope it is clear to all. You can understand well what is in fifth. Fifth का आप देख सकते हो क्या है? Carving of the crow hidden in the foliage. इस तरह से आप देख सकते हो. क्वेश्चन नंबर जो आपका ये है, ठीक है, इसका भी आप ऑप्शन 4 का देख सकते हो. 4 का इसमें दिया हुआ ए क्या इसमें है, हैज़ गिवन माय हार्ट ए चेंज ऑफ मूड. इसके बाद आप देख सकते हो जो आपका नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन है, क्वेश्चन नंबर आपका 3 है, इसमें दिया हुआ है आपका जो क्वेश्चन दिया हुआ है ये आपका है डी फॉर्म को आप देख सकते हैं. इस तरह से आप देख सकते हैं जो क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 है, सेकंड का बी, फर्स्ट का आप देखेंगे सी है, हीलिंग दिया हुआ है, और सेकंड का आपका जो है वो आपको हमने बता दिया आपको बी ऑप्शन है, ठीक है. इस तरह से ये जो ऑप्शन आपका है ये क्वेश्चन कंप्लीट हुआ. अब हम डिस्कस करने जा रहे हैं, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस answer in 20 to 30 word. Now we are going to discuss answer is 20 to 30 word. See here the first, crystallize what you think the poet was probably doing when dust of snow fell on him. Crystallize what you think the poet was probably doing when the dust of snow fell on him. The second question, what does the presence of a hemlock tree tell you about the setting of the poem? So here the question first. Rationalize what you think the poet was probably doing when the dust of snow fell on him. Next, what does the presence of a hemlock tree tell you about the setting of the poem? Question third, the dusting of snow on account of the crow, dusting of snow on account of the crow helped make the poet's day better. How do you think the crow's dropping might have impacted the poet? Here are given some question. Here are given three question. Now see here question number 11. Question number, now see the answer here. Answer in 20 to 34, okay? Question number 11, 40 to 50 words. Here are given some question. Dust of Snow is one of Frost's most loved poem. Elaborate why you think this is so. This answer must be given in 40 to 50 words. Now second, poem evokes a sense of black and white. Justify, आपको इसको justify करना है कि जो poem है वो evokes करते हैं. फिर crow and hemlock are usually used as a negative reference in literature. जैसा कि आप देख रहे हैं crow और hemlock को एक negative reference के रूप में literature में use किया जाता है. How is this different this poem? Poem जो है उससे difference कैसे है, ये पोएम की जो आंसरिंग रेशियो है उससे अलग कैसे है. इस तरह से आपने देखा कि यू आर गिवेन सम क्वेश्चन, थ्री क्वेश्चन टू अटेंड बाय योरसेल्फ, आपको स्वयं इसको अटेंड करना है. यू आर गिवेन थ्री क्वेश्चन, दे आर रेशनलाइज व्हाट यू थिंक द पोएट वाज प्रोबेबली डूइंग व्हेन द डस्ट ऑफ स्नो फेल ऑन हिम. सेकेंड, व्हाट डज द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ए हेमलॉक ट्री tell you about the setting of the poem. And third question, the dusting of the snow on account the crow helped make the poet's way better. How do you think the crow's dropping might have impact of the poet? These are the questions which we had to attempt. ये सारे question हैं जिसको आपको attempt करने हैं. अब हम discuss करने जा रहे हैं आपके ये जो question है जिसको आपने देखा, ठीक है. तो now see here are given some question about 40 to 50 words. अब ध्यान से देखिए इसको दिया है. यहाँ डस्ट ऑफ स्नो इज वन ऑफ फ्रॉस्ट मोस्ट लव्ड पोएम. इलेबरेट वाई यू थिंक दिस इज सो. अब आपको इलेबरेट करना है, इसको डिस्क्राइब करना है कि ऐसा क्यों है. द पोएम इवोक्स अ सेंस ऑफ ब्लैक एंड वाइट. जस्टिफाई. थर्ड क्वेश्चन है, क्रो एंड हेमलॉक आर यूजली यूज एज नेगेटिव रेफरेंस इन लिटरेचर, बट हाउ इज दिस डिफरेंट इन द पोएम. लेकिन पोएम में उसको नेगेटिव रेफरेंस नहीं दिया गया है, उसको पॉजिटिव रेफरेंस दिया गया है. आपको बताना है कि कैसी जो पोएम है वो पॉजिटिव रेफरेंस में काम करती है. अब हम डिस्कस करने जा रहे हैं. आपका देखिए दिया हुआ है, ये आपका आंसर है. आंसर इन 100 to 120 बियॉन्ड टेक्स्ट एंड अक्रॉस टेक्स्ट. कुछ ऐसे क्वेश्चन होंगे जो टेक्स्ट से परे हैं, कुछ ऐसे क्वेश्चन जो टेक्स्ट रिलेटेड है. आप इससे मतलब आपको क्वेश्चन को अंडरस्टैंड करना है और सेल्फ आंसरिंग करना है. देखिए यहाँ दिया हुआ है, एज ए क्रो यू फील हाईली इंसर्ट बाय द इनकरेक्ट परसेप्शन. देखिए आप दे रहा है या कंपेयर कर रहा है कि एज ए क्रो यू फील हाईली इंसर्ट बाय द इनकरेक्ट परसेप्शंस ह्यूमंस हैव अबाउट योर स्पेसिस. ह्यूमंस हैव अबाउट योर स्पेसिस. इमेजिन योर सेल्फ टू बी ए क्रो एंड राइट योर ओपिनियन अबाउट द प्रिजुडिसेस. मेक अ केस फॉर ब्रेकिंग स्टीरियोटाइप्स. तो मतलब आप जो प्रिजुडिसेस जो होते हैं उसके ऊपर आप केस करके उसको आप कंप्लीट करेंगे. तो ये तो हो गया आपका फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन जिसको आपको डिस्क्राइब करना है. सी वंस अगेन, एज ए क्रो यू फील हाईली इंसल्ट बाय द इनकरेक्ट परसेप्शन. ह्यूमंस हैव अबाउट योर स्पेसिस. इमेजिन योर सेल्फ टू बी ए क्रो एंड राइट योर ओपिनियन अबाउट दिस प्रेजुडिसेस. मेक ए केस फॉर ब्रेकिंग स्टीरियोटाइप्स. Imagine second question. Now see the second question. Second question is given here. Imagine that first of the present day. Imagine that first is of present day and has been invited to write for an zine, Tin Tak. See here once again. Imagine that first is the present. Frost is a present day and has been invited to write for an isn't Tin Tak. He chose to draw upon his experience. He chose to draw upon his experience with the crow and dusting up snow to share his thought on every cloud has a silver lining. As Frost express your thought for the isn. Now see here once again. Imagine that Frost is a present day and has been invited to write for an isn. Tin Tak. मतलब isn ये इसको आपको इन्वाइट करते हैं इसमें लिखने के लिए आपको. He choose to draw upon experience. वो कहते हैं कि अपना अनुभव जो है आप शेयर करो ठीक है. With the crow and crow ke saath and the dusting of snow to share his thought on every clouds has a silver lining. As forest express your thought for the reason. Here are given some question for attending you. You must attend these all question as I have told the answer of multiple choice question. Then after your second question is answer in 20 to 30 words. The third question is answer in 40 to 50 words. And the last question is answer in 100 to 20 words. In this, with the help of this question, you just try to imagine the answer, write the answer and match this answer through different sources. Thanks to watch my video.